Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the next property, that is shielding effect, and let us talk about its trend in periodic table also. So let us go on. So let us understand what is actually screening or shielding effect. The inner shell electrons in an atom screen or shield the outermost valence electrons. So this is true. That is, the inner shell electrons in an atom actually shield or prevent the outermost electron from the attraction of the nucleus, to the attraction of the nucleus, from the nuclear attraction. This effect is known as basically shielding effect or screening effect. This is what I have explained earlier also, but let me explain it again. For example, if we are talking about an atom which would consist of a nucleus and various shells, as you could see. So this shells would consist of electrons, as we know. This would consist of various electrons. So for an instance, I am just drawing 4 electrons in the second shell, but actually it is the maximum limit that it could contain electron is 8. So in this thing, suppose if I have drawn an atom in this way. So what is actually shielding effect? Shielding effect will be nothing but the inner electrons, or the inner electrons which are present in the inner shell. As you could see, this is the outermost shell, and the electrons are said to be the outermost electrons, while these are the inner shell or the innermost shell. So what happens is, because of these inner electrons that are present very close to that of the nucleus, what will happen, because of which the nuclear charge will go on increasing towards this electrons, and because of which the attraction of this inner electrons will be more in case when we are talking about the inner electrons. So what happens is, if the number of electron increases, and moreover if we see that if we are talking about the orbitals like s, p, d and f, so it has been observed that the s orbitals have basically more shielding effect than compared to p, compared to d and compared to f. So the nuclear charge is nothing but the force of attraction between the nucleus and the outermost electron. So as you could see that these are the outermost electron, so they should have attraction with this nucleus. So there should be an attraction with this nucleus. So therefore this is known as basically nuclear charge. But this nuclear charge can reduce or can decrease also. It depends on basically the inner electrons, as you could see here. So it depends on the inner electrons, and inner electrons plays a very vital role. As you could see here, this inner electrons plays very vital role. Because the more the number of electrons in the inner shell, so they will try to protect the nucleus so as to attract the outermost electron. So this kind of protection, or we could see that this kind of screening where the nucleus is not being allowed to attract towards the outermost electron. So this kind of screening, this kind of effect that is shown by the inner orbitals or the inner shells, when we are talking about the inner electrons, so this kind of prevention or this kind of screening is basically known as shielding effect. So therefore, because of which the nuclear charge will not be more in case of the outermost electron. So this is basically known as screening effect. So now let us talk about what would be the trend if we observe in periodic table. So the trend that we are talking about, that is in periods and in groups. So there will be two discussions that we are going to do. That is, the first one is in periods. So what kind of variation that we could observe when we observe a period in a periodic table? So the first thing that we observe in the when we go through a period of a periodic table, and we are concerned with the screening effect, and that is the first point that we are going to discuss. As we move from left to right, what happens is atomic number increases, and that increase will be gradual. So first of all, the atomic number increases gradually. And the second point that we are going to discuss about, that is the electron that enters in the outer outermost shell will be in the same shell itself. For example, when we are talking about the period, then the electrons are entering, the new electrons are been entering in the same shell. For example, if I would say for sodium, we have the outermost shell known as 3s, and that 3s will consist of one electron. But when we are talking about magnesium, magnesium has an atomic number of 12, which means that it consists of 12 electrons. So this extra electron, this 12th electron, this will enter in the last shell, that is 3s shell only, or 3s subshell only. So because every time we will add an electron in the period, so that electron will add in the same main subshell. So that is the reason what happens is because of the electrons that are been increasing in the same subshell or in the same main shell, because of which the atomic number increases, as well as we could say that the nuclear charge will also increase. So the second point that we are going to say it as, the electron enters in the same main shell. The new electron, that is we are talking about, the new electron will enter in the same main shell. And most of all, what we could observe is, we could observe that the nuclear charge will go on increasing. Because if the number of electrons are being on the same shell, and that shell is nothing but the outermost shell, as we could observe, so that usually the outermost shell will have more attraction towards the nucleus, and because of which what happens, the inner electrons will remain constant throughout that thing, and because of which the nuclear charge will increase. There is nuclear charge increase, and because of what we could observe that the screening effect is less. And because of which, because the nuclear charge is increasing, that it obviously it means that when it comes to period, when we are talking about period, then the screening effect actually it decreases. It decreases, and that's the reason what happens, because of the nuclear charge is increasing, and moreover we could say that the screening effect is less or it decreases. That's the reason the atomic size goes on decreasing when we are talking about when we are in concern with the screening effect in terms of periods. So now let us talk about what will happen when we are in concern with the trend in group. So now what happens in group actually? So as we move from up to down, what we could observe is that the atomic number goes on increasing, but that increases very much rapid. This is what we have explained earlier also. So I would name the first point, that is main concern that we observe in the trend of for the screening effect. The first point that we could observe is that as we move from up to down, the atomic number increases rapidly, or we could say very vast change when we move from up to down in the same group. Similarly, I have talked about this earlier also. For example, if I'm talking about lithium, lithium has an atomic number of 3. While talking about the sodium, which is belong to the same block, or we could say which is belong to the same group, that is S block that we are talking about, then what happens is lithium, sodium, potassium, and going on further down, we could see that the atomic number goes on increasing rapidly. So now this is what we have written here. Because of the atomic number increases rapidly, and we could observe that the electrons that are been increasing, this will lead to the number of shells will not remain the same throughout when we are talking in terms of period. It will go on increasing. So therefore the number of shell or the number of main shell increases. The number of main shell increases. For example, if I am talking about lithium, lithium has an atomic number of 3, so I could write it as 1s2, 2s2, 1s2, 2s1. That means the outermost shell it has basically 2 shells. But when we are talking about sodium, we could write it as the electronic configuration sodium as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So the number of main shell is now 3. And when we are talking about the potassium, so again it will have an extra main shell. So what happens is the number of shell will go on increasing. So because of the number of shell will go on increasing, that means that the number of inner electron will also go on increasing. So therefore, the number of inner electrons increases. And because of this inner electron, they go on increasing. So what will happen actually, the inner electrons will try to shield the nucleus so as it should not have that much influence on the outermost electron. And this is basically known as shielding effect. And shielding effect is mainly observed when we move from up to down, down the group. And that's the reason, because of the inner electrons that increases when we move down to the group. So therefore, this will result in increase in screening effect. So therefore, screening effect increases, and that's the reason what happens is. So that's the reason what happens is the nuclear charge goes on decreasing. So that's what the nuclear charge, it decreases. And since the nuclear charge goes on decreasing, that's the reason the atomic size goes on increasing. So it is not only because there are various factors that will affect the atomic size. So among that, we have also studied that among that, the main shell was also the main reason. Because as we move from left to right, that is along the period, so the atomic shell, that is the number of shell, it remains constant. While when we come up to down, that is down to the group, so atomic shell or the number of shell, it goes on increasing, as well as the number of electrons also goes on increasing. But when we are concerned with the screening effect, then we could observe that the inner electrons also goes on increasing, that results in more screening effect. And hence, we could see that the nuclear charge decreases and hence the atomic size increases. So let me give you a short example of this so that you could understand in a very better way. So for this example, let me talk about a period. Suppose the same like sodium, if I would concern about that thing. Sodium and magnesium. So in periods, what we observe is, when we are talking about sodium and magnesium, sodium has an atomic number of 11, while magnesium has atomic number of 12, and they both are belonging to the same period. So in this case, suppose if I draw the schematic atomic structure of sodium, so it would mainly consist of three shells, while the magnesium, it will also consist of the same shells, that is same number of shells as I've drawn here. So the thing is, the outermost electron, the outermost shell will consist of one electron when it comes to sodium, while when it comes to the magnesium, it will consist of basically two electrons. And moreover, what we could observe is, we could observe that the inner electron in this case are basically 10, because the second shell, the first shell includes two electrons, while the second shell consist of 8 electrons. So it consists of 8 electrons, and moreover here also it would be the same, that is 8 electrons would be here and 2 electrons will be the innermost shell. So as we move from left to right, so the main shell remains the constant, means it might be sodium, magnesium or aluminium and it will silicon and it will go on. So the number of shell remains the main shell remains constant. And because of which what happens is the inner electrons also remain the same, and but moreover what we could observe is that the electrons are entering the outermost shell. And because the electrons have been entering the outermost shell, so what will happen, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the outermost shell, it will be more, and that is the reason we could also observe that the atomic size goes on decreasing, because the nuclear charge goes on increasing. And we could see that there will be no drastic change in screening effect, because the inner electrons will also remain the same throughout the whole, when we are talking about the period. So that's the reason the screening effect has not so much of change, and because of which the atomic size decreases. So this was related to period. So let me talk about when we are talking about a group. So when we are talking about a group, for example, I will take the first example as lithium. First we take lithium, and then lithium has an atomic number of 3, while sodium which has atomic number of basically 11. So, this is the second, after lithium, it comes sodium. So, as we could see that the atomic number doesn't change gradually by unitary number, but it changes drastically, as we could see that the atomic number is 3, but now you could see here it is basically 11, and below that you could see K19. So the more thing, suppose if I draw a schematic diagram of this thing, so for lithium what I could draw is, it would consist of basically 2 electrons in the first shell, and the outermost electron will contain basically 1 electron. So but when we are have drawn the structure or the atomic diagram of sodium, so I could write it in this way. It would consist of 2 electrons in the outermost shell, in the first shell, and after that it would contain 8 electrons, and the outermost shell would contains 1 electron. So in this case, what we could observe is, we could observe that the outermost electron consists of 1 electron throughout the whole group. But the main thing is that the inner electrons, it also changes drastically. Because in lithium, the inner electrons are 2 electrons, while talking about the sodium, which is next, which is just down to the lithium, it has total number of 10 electrons. 10 electrons in the innermost or in the inner electrons, inner shells. So that's the reason this inner electrons, this 10 inner electrons are comparatively more than that of these 2 inner electrons, which makes the sodium to have more screening effect or more shielding effect, because of which this 10 electrons, they will prevent the nucleus to have an attraction towards the outermost electron. That's the reason as we move down to a group, we could see that the screening effect goes on increasing, and that's the reason the nuclear charge goes on decreasing, and yes, the atomic size goes on increasing. So this was the trend that I wanted to showcase you. So it was very much simple to understand. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have also understood that what is actually screening effect and what are the trends of it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you will share this video, and yes, you will not forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.